This is Winner's Longhorn Build 5048, the official developer preview build of Winner's Vista, and we're gonna take a deep look at this build and compare several changes to its final version. Our first look is at the desktop. The background change is the most visible one, followed by the recycle bin icon change to resemble the final version, the build tag at the bottom right corner of the screen, and the taskbar theme being changed from Luna to somewhat metallic, I assume. Before we go forward in this build, let's check out the setup. The setup starts with the boot screen, which feels more like XP than Vista with the logo, as Vista doesn't have a logo on the boot screen. The appearance looks similar to builds before this, and it is somewhat similar to what we have in Windows Vista with the progress bar right there. Unfortunately, you can't partition a drive in this setup like you'd usually do. There's some dishry needed for this, but for me, I'm gonna use Gparted Partition Manager inside of Parted Magic. What a lazy little mustard. After that, the setup goes smoothly as expected. Well, apart from the setup taking quite a bit of time. After the second boot and VMware tools, Windows is ready and we can finally check our changes and additions in this build. Back at the desktop, looking at the start menu, it has some changes from Windows XP. Well, other than the icon changes, search is added, although a bit quirky, all programs list is now shown inside of the menu rather than popping out from it. And the log off button is providing more options to other actions. Opening the Windows Explorer, we can see that the layout changed, mainly because task pane doesn't exist, and replaced by the command bar, like in Windows Vista. Other feature changes include details pane, disk space indicator, search box, and what's supposed to be a breadcrumb. Although it has good changes, I find it funny at how some of the features are ambiguous, such as the details pane changing position depending on what directory or folder you're in. It can be at the top and at the bottom. Explorer also displays only 50 items, sometimes. Very weird. Tree view can be visible or not visible. The window layout in this build still resembles Windows XP, but it will be different when we enable Aero later on. Oh yeah, also, the control panel icon is using its Windows 9X version rather than XP. Next, control panel. The layout looks nothing like Vista at first, but by how it has subcategories inside of each category makes it kind of Vista-ish. Classic view is still viewable, albeit, well, kind of unsorted. Right-clicking the desktop takes us to desktop properties. Wait, we only have Aero in here, right? Well, there is the Windows XP theme, and yeah, you can apply it. Boom, we have Windows XP! And not only that, you have Bliss and functional Lunar theme. And not just that again, you can enable the XP logon screen by going to user account applet and enabling the welcome screen. After that, log off, and there you go! The Windows XP logon screen, how cool is that? I think it is very cool. Alright, control panel also has other additional applets such as sync manager, a new add new program variant, new change or remove programs applet, brand new always in applications update applets, and network device installations applet. You might notice that the font in this build is smooth and not jagged like XP, because, well, clear type is enabled by default. Moving to system applications, the quadrinity of basic applications such as calculator, notepad, paint, and wordpad, they are the same as XP. As for other applications, Windows Media Player is version 10, which is what Windows XP Media Center Edition bundled with. Internet Explorer Encode 6 that has Longhorn appearance, a simplified Windows search with the traditional version available as a toolbar. Other applications are taken from XP like Task Manager, Sound Recorder, Address Book, and Remote Desktop Connection. Weirdly enough, some applications don't exist, like msconfig and Help Center, which should be available from the start menu. Well, it doesn't exist. Or is it? It does exist, just under a different file name, helppane.exe. It is still heavily plain because of its earliness. You can't run on-screen keyboard in this build because of, well, invalid configuration. Movie Maker and System Restore also don't exist. Windows XP games are in here, albeit stripped. Look at Minesweeper as the example, and I swear I may have the shortest Minesweeper game ever, while losing in easy mode. Jeez, I am a loser. Checking out the WinVer, the banner uses the same Longhorn graphic as earlier builds. This is supported by... Why is the start menu not responding? Dang! Task Manager! After a dictionary, you can see that the Longhorn codename is in the system properties too. Before we move on, I want to showcase a neat addition to this build. WinSAT, or well, you may know it as Windows Experience Index. It has its early form under the original name and runs via command prompt. Launching it will ask you for command switches, and providing the help switch will open an offline web page. The web page describes the program's ability to test out overall program, disk assessment, or memory assessment. All those guides are linked to an internal Microsoft web page. As for sample media, well, no changes so far. Alright, let's check out some of the interesting changes in this build! Well, first and foremost, DWM. That one feature Longhorn is famously known of. It is disabled by default, and you need some registry addition to the OS for correct configuration, which includes window glass reflections, caption box style, and others. After the configuration, you can finally start the Aero via run DLL32. There we go! Aero! You can see that the caption box has been drastically changed. This one has the XP-like caption box. The glassy look at the title bar is quite frosty, and the height is, well, too short. There is another caption box variant that looks similar to Vista, but again, it's too small. The old tab interface still looks the same as XP. And the amazing part of this is, well, window animation. Even though it's a bit clunky because it's laggy, we know it's because of emulation thingy. Apart from that, the restore animation looks cool, although it needs some rework to polish it. Another interesting change in this build is UAC, which is User Account Control, makes its debut. A prototype of the feature is included in this build. To enable it, you need to create an additional administrator account and a limited account, which you can do in the User Account applet. After that, put this text and save it as a .reg file, which we will merge later. In the welcome screen, by logging in as a standard account, you will be prompted by the UAC for the first time, and you need to enter an administrator password, which I bloody forgot. We'll be right back. Finally, we can see the UAC feature in action, and we can see either allow or deny the program. Allowing the program will prompt you for an administrator password, strangely enough, this standard account lacks the turn off computer button on the start menu. The last one is Red Screen of Death, which you can summon by deleting system files such as hal.dll, and by restarting the OS, well, there we go. This build of Windows Longhorn has its concept that would later be implemented in Windows Vista. Those features were actually already implemented, but due to chaotic development, the big reset happens, and they have to re-implement some of the features. Even after all that, Windows Vista was released with mostly negative reception due to demanding system requirement at the time. Despite its negative impression, we can see how Microsoft developed one of the most feature-rich versions of Windows. What about the next version after Vista? Well, you know how it happens.